Look at this picture. What do you see? This is a block of butter. Now, this represents what? A solid? Now, this solid, it has a particular length, a particular breadth, and a particular height, just like any solid. Now, let me slice this. Now, you can see I have sliced this block of butter. Now, what I have done? I have created new faces here. And if you overturn this, you can see its face here also, like this. Now, these faces, they have equal length, equal breadth. Now, what are these faces called? Well, these faces, they are called cross-section. So, whenever we slice or we cut any solid, the face that is created is called cross-section. Now, this face, it has some area also. Now, this area can be calculated by length into breadth. Now, this area is actually called cross-sectional area. So, now you know what is cross-section. This is the face that is created when we cut any solid, and the area is called cross-sectional area. Now, let's take the example of this solid. You can see that this is a cucumber. Now, in what ways can you slice a cucumber? Well, you can cut it along its length, or you can cut it from here in the middle, that is along its breadth. So, you can say that if a cut is made through a solid perpendicular to its length, that is through its length, or breadth or height. Here we have cut this along its breadth. Or you can cut any solid along its height also. Then the surface so obtained is called its cross section. So now you are clear with the term cross section. Now here you can see that we have sliced this block of butter and we have sliced the loaves of bread also. What do you observe? You can see that they are having the same length, breadth and height. Now all its faces, take any face, you'll see they have the same length, breadth and height. So what is the cross section in this case called? Well, it is called uniform cross section. So what is uniform cross section? If the surface made by the cut has the same shape, here you can see they're having the same shape, or the bread, each bread has the same shape and size. They are having the same size. Each bread has the same size at every point of its length, breadth or height in whichever way we have cut it. So we have cut this along its length or we have cut that along its breadth. So each and every face is having the same shape and the same size. Then it is called a uniform cross section. So you can say the cross section made here is uniform. And in this block of butter, this is also uniform. That is why if you take the solid cylinder, now you cut the cylinder at any point, you will see that the face created has the same shape and the same size. Even in the case of cuboid or in the case of cube, you can see if you cut it along its length or its breadth or its height, the face created has the same shape and the same size. So this is called a uniform cross section. But you can see that in the case of this onion or this tomato, what happens? If you cut it from here, the size is smaller than if you cut it from here. Now this has a greater size than this. So that means if you cut this onion from various places, the face created will not have the same size. Maybe the shape is same, but the size is different. Even in the case of tomato, you can see here the size is also different and the shape is also different. So this is called a non-uniform cross section. So these have non-uniform cross sections. So which solids can have non-uniform cross sections? Well, a cone. Take the example of a cone. If I cut it from three sides, say like this, you can see that this face is of a greater size than this face. So you can say that a cone does not have a uniform cross section. Now, even in case of sphere, you can see that they do not have a uniform cross section. So now you know what is a cross section. A cross section is a cut made through a solid perpendicular to its length, breadth or height. Then the surface so obtained is actually called the cross section. And the area of that surface is called the cross sectional area. Now cross section can be uniform or non-uniform. Now uniform in cases such as cube, cuboids or cylinders, and non-uniform in the cases of cones or spheres and hemispheres. Now remember that you can find the volume of those solids who are having uniform cross section by this method also, where volume of those solids will be area of cross section into length, breadth or height, whichever is given. And the lateral surface area can also be calculated by perimeter of the cross section, that is that cross section, into length, breadth or height, whichever is given. Now these two formulas can be helpful in only those solids which are having uniform cross section. So note this point, that a volume can be calculated of a solid which has uniform cross section by this formula, where volume is area of cross section into length, breadth or height, whichever is mentioned, and the lateral surface area of that solid which has uniform cross section will be perimeter of cross section into length, breadth or height, whichever is given.